universal soldier. He's still out there. He's 5'2" and he's 6'4". He fights with missiles and with spears. He's all of 31 and he's only 17. He's been a soldier for 1,000 years. He's a Catholic, a Hindu, an atheist, a Jain, a Buddhist, and a Baptist, and a Jew. He knows he shouldn't kill, he knows he always will. Kill it for me, my friend, and me. And he's fighting for Canada, he's fighting for France, fighting for the USA, the fighting for the Russians, and he's fighting for Japan. He thinks we'll put an end to war this way. Fighting for democracy, he's fighting for the Reds. He says it's for the peace of us all. He's the one who must decide who's to live and who's to die. He never sees the writing on the wall. But without him, how would Hitler have condemned him in Dachau? Without him, Caesar would have stood alone. He's the one who gives his body as a weapon of the war. Without him, all this killing can't go on. He's the universal soldier, and he really is to blame. His orders come from far away no more. They come from here and there, and you and me, and brothers, can't you see, sisters too? This is not the way we put the end to war.